In tutorial number 5, we would like to give you a general overview of size exclusion chromatography and a consideration of applications in aqueous, GFC, and organic, GPC, media. First of all, we want to start with aqueous-based gel filtration chromatography. The corresponding best-selling Shodex columns are the protein KW and OH pack SB series. The main applications in this mode are the separation and analysis of water-soluble macromolecules like proteins, enzymes, and antibodies. Therefore, these types of columns are mainly used in the fields of life science, biotechnology, and pharmaceutical industry. If you need more detailed information about size exclusion chromatography, as well as about protein analysis, please take a look at our technical notebooks number 5 and 7, which you can find on our website. Size exclusion chromatography is mainly used for the separation of macromolecule mixtures and for the determination of molecular weight as well as molecular weight distribution of the corresponding compound of interest. Moreover, this separation mode is not based on physical interactions between analytes and the surface of the packing material, but by the size of the analyte in solution. Thereby, the cooperation of the pores of the stationary phase and the hydrodynamic volume or diameter of the macromolecule in the sulfated state is the key factor for a successful separation. Consequently, sulfated polymers with small hydrodynamic volumes can diffuse in every accessible pore. Therefore, smaller compounds will retain longer on the column and dilute later than bigger compounds, which can only diffuse into the larger pores. When size exclusion columns have to be chosen for a certain application, several facts have to be considered. In general, for every size exclusion column, the pore sizes and also the exclusion limit are given as typical characteristics. Under aqueous conditions, the exclusion limit is determined by different standards like polyulin, which is an unbranched polysaccharide, and proteins. In case the compound has a bigger hydrodynamic diameter than the maximum pore size diameter, no diffusion into the pores is possible. Therefore, no separation above this limit is possible. The same effect occurs when the compound has a significant smaller hydrodynamic diameter than the smallest pore size available. In this case, the compound will retain on the column much longer and ends up in a retarded elution. This limit is called permeation limit. Therefore, when you have to choose a column, it has to be ensured that the molecular weight range of your sample lies between both limits to achieve a separation and to obtain a correct result. In size exclusion chromatography, there are two possibilities to determine the molecular weight and the molecular weight distribution of the compound of interest, either by absolute or relative methods. The latter method can be divided in conventional and universal calibration method. In the case of conventional calibration, only concentration-sensitive detectors, in most cases RI detectors, are used. For universal calibration methods, concentration-sensitive detectors are combined, preferably with viscometers, which are molar mass-sensitive detectors. For both calibration types, standards with known molecular weight and narrow molecular weight distribution have to be used. Shodex is also offering standards, i.e. polyulin for aqueous applications, polystyrene and polymethyl metacrylate for applications in organic solvents. The principle of conventional calibration is described on the bottom of the slide. First of all, standards with known and different molecular weights are analyzed and a calibration curve is created. In the second step, the sample with the unknown molecular weight is analyzed. Finally, the sample is compared to the calibration curve and the molecular weight of the sample can be determined relative to standard. As mentioned on the previous slides, Shodex is also selling standards for calibration purposes. Polyulin for aqueous applications, polystyrene and polymethyl metacrylate for applications in organic solvents. In the case of polyulin, a standard kit with 8 standards within a molecular weight range from 5,900 and 708,000 Dalton can be purchased. Moreover, also single-type standards are available. Polystyrene is a standard for size exclusion chromatography in organic solvents. It is highly soluble in THF, chloroform, toluene, and orthodichlorobenzene. Shodex is offering 3 different standard kits. The kit SL-105 contains 10 different single standards with a range between 580 and 21,800 Dalton. The kit SM-105 contains also 10 different single standards within a range from 1,270 to 2,700,000 Dalton. The third kit, SH-75, contains 7 single standards ranging from 591,000 to 6,870,000 Dalton. A further standard for size exclusion chromatography in organic solvents is polymethyl methacrylate. This standard is highly soluble in hexafluoroisopropanol as well as DMF. For this standard, Shodex offers the standard kit M-75, which contains 7 different single standards within a range between 2,890 and 955,000 Dalton. For the standards used in organic solvents, no single standards are available. One of Shodex's top-selling columns for the analysis of high molecular weight compounds under aqueous conditions is the protein KW-800 series. They are biofully porous silica particles, which are modified with highly hydrophilic groups on their surface, are used. This column series is mainly used to separate and analyze peptides, proteins, enzymes, and antibodies. The stationary phase is stable between a pH range of 3 and 7.5. In general, buffers are used as eluent, with salt concentrations between 0.1 and 0.3 molar. Furthermore, the base material is also stable towards organic solvents like methanol, ethanol, and acetonitrile. Consequently, also less water-soluble compounds can be analyzed under organic conditions. In general, the best-selling protein KW columns are the KW-800 and KW-400 series, whereby the latter is known as the high-performance type. The KW-800 series are offered with 3 different pore sizes. The smallest one, with a maximum pore size of 400 angstrom, is the protein KW-802.5, which leads to an exclusion limit of 60,000 Dalton for polyolin and 150,000 Dalton for proteins. Moreover, the protein KW-803 can be used for compounds with higher molecular weight. It has a maximum pore size of 1,000 angstrom, which results in an exclusion limit of 170,000 Dalton for polyolin and 700,000 Dalton for proteins. In the case of the protein KW-804, the maximum pore size is 1,500 angstrom. Therefore, polyolin reaches an exclusion limit of 500,000 Dalton and proteins an estimated limit of 1 million Dalton. The main differences between the KW-800 series and the KW-400 series are the smaller particle sizes, smaller column size, and higher plate numbers. These properties lead to less solvent consumption and higher resolution. A direct comparison between both column series is shown on this slide. Thereby, in both cases, protein mixtures containing, for example, gamma globulin, ovalbumin, and myoglobin are analyzed. In both cases, a separation could be observed, whereby in the case of the KW-400 series, a better resolution as well as higher peak intensity could be observed. For the following analysis of standard proteins, like for example transferrin, albumin, and hemoglobin, a combination of 2 protein KW-803 columns were used to increase the plate number and therefore the resolution. Thereby, you can see that you get a nice shift in elution volume from heavy or bigger proteins, like fibrinogen, towards smaller ones, like hemoglobin. Moreover, it is important to emphasize that a combination of 2 columns with different pore sizes is also possible to cover a wide range of molecular weight. In this example, a complex whey sample containing different proteins was analyzed by combining KW-402.5F and KW-403-4F columns. Thereby, a nice separation with high resolution of all proteins could be obtained. In the case, different water-soluble macromolecules like synthetic polymers, polysaccharides, surfactants or PAG proteins have to be separated and analyzed, the use of the OH-PAC SB-800 column series can be recommended. The base material of this series consists of pure polymer-based particles, made out of polyhydroxymethacrylate. Therefore, this stationary phase is stable in a broader pH range from 3 to 10. In general, pure water and/or buffers can be used as eluent. Furthermore, a replacement of the aqueous eluent by organic solvents like DMF, and to some extent by methanol and acetonitrile, is possible to be able to dissolve also less water-soluble compounds. In our catalogue, you can find further information which columns of this series can be used with organic solvents and with which maximal content. In the case of the OH-PAC SB-800 column series, a wider variety of pore sizes are available than in the case of the protein KW column series. Therefore, the SB-800 series can cover a broader molecular weight range. For example, the OH-PAC SB-802HQ column covers the low molecular weight range from 100 to 4000 Dalton with a maximum pore size of 100 angstrom. In contrast to that, the OH-PAC SB-806HQ has a maximum pore size of 15,000 angstrom and is able to cover a range of from 100,000 Dalton up to an estimated value of 20 million Dalton. For ultra-high molecular weight polymers, the use of the OH-PAC SB-807HQ is recommended. Beside single gel columns, also a mixed gel column can be offered. The OH-PAC SB-806M consists of different gels and therefore shows a good linearity over a broad molecular weight range. To visualize the broad application range of the mixed gel column OH-PAC SB-806M, dextrin sulfate samples were analyzed. Thereby, two columns in a row were combined to increase the plate number and therefore the resolution. The examples confirm that mixed gel columns cover a wide molecular range, in this case 5,000 Dalton samples as well as 500,000 Dalton samples can be analyzed with the same setup. Moreover, polydispersed polyacrylamide samples with an average molecular weight of 5,500,000 Dalton were analyzed under aqueous conditions using two different OH-PAC SB columns in combination with refractive index and multi-angle light scattering detectors. The comparison between the columns SB-806 and SB-807 clearly shows the importance of the polymer size in solution. Considering the average molecular weight will lead to the conclusion that the column SB-806 is enough for a good separation in this case, but as you can see in the chromatogram, the higher molecular weight fragments are close to the exclusion limit. Therefore, for a correct analysis of this polymer, the use of SB-807 with a significant higher exclusion limit is recommended. Another important fact when you have to choose a column for size exclusion chromatography is to consider the base materials which are used for the stationary phases. In the case of proteins, a silica-based column is usually the better choice, as it shows a more flattened calibration curve in this case, which leads to a significant better separation than in the case of polymer-based columns like SB-803 and GF-510. For synthetic materials which are insoluble under aqueous conditions, size exclusion chromatography with organic solvents has to be applied. This method is also known as gel permeation chromatography. If you need further information about application as well as properties of our products in this area, please take a look at our technical notebook number 1. One of our most important best-selling column series is the GPC KF-800. Which is a fully polymer-based column. Thereby, styrene divinyl benzene copolymer particles are used as stationary phase. In general, this column series is used for the analysis of compounds within a wide molecular weight distribution, for example, rubber, polycarbonate resins, etc. The standard eluent for the KF-800 series is THF. In the case you have to work with different organic solvents, solvent replacement is also possible. Consequently, solvents like, for example, chloroform, toluene, carbon tetrachloride, etc., can also be used. For more detailed information, you can find a solvent replacement table in our catalogue. Moreover, this type of column is also available as K-800 series and KD-800 series. In the former case, chloroform is used as shipping solvent, whereas in the latter, dimethyl formamide. In the following table, you can see an overview of the huge variation in the case of the KF-800 column series. Thereby, different pore sizes resulting in different exclusion limits can be offered to determine polymers within a certain molecular weight range. In addition, besides single-gel columns, Shodex is also producing mixed-gel columns marked with either L or M. In the case of the mixed-gel columns, a better linear behavior over a wide molecular weight range can be obtained. In the case of L, this linearity is still available for compounds below 10,000 Dalton, whereas in the case of M, the analysis of over 10,000 Dalton is more suitable. The performance of the KF-800L columns is shown in this slide. Therefore, we've tested different polystyrene standards over a wide molecular weight range. On the left side, you can see a combination of two 803L columns, which lead to good separation of polystyrenes from 92 up to 133,000 Dalton in a high resolution. On the right side, two 807L columns were combined to separate a polystyrene mixture between the range of 92 and 19,825,000 Dalton. In this case also, a nice separation with a high resolution was obtained, confirming the good performance of mixed gel columns over a broad range. If you need further info material, please register on our new website www.shodex.de. There you can find PDF files for download, i.e. our column and detector catalogues, technical notebooks, and you have access to our application data bank. In the case you need support, please contact us via info@shodex.de. For quotes or purchase orders, please send us an email via order@shodex.de. Moreover, we offer further tutorials considering reversed phase, hillock, ligand exchange, and ion chromatography. Thank you very much for your kind attention.